Okay, good morning. We're doing some bell work today. Don't forget that you have retest sign up over there on the wall, and you must sign up by this Friday in order to retest next Wednesday in class. Also, I have some lead. I have 0.5 and 0.7. I know I gave you guys lead pencils, so if you need some lead, just let me know. All right, and these say fine volume. But before I do that, there's one more thing. If you were absent yesterday, this is worth 20 points right here. And these are some links on construction. And I have them right up here on my stool. And here are the links right here. You can maybe hone in on them at home if you need to. Actually, I can probably make that a little bit bigger for you. And then you can pause it and go from there. But what I want you to do is to put a heading, like constructing congruent angles is one of them. And then I want you to go through the steps and write the steps. I want you to memorize the steps, but make sure you write down the steps. And again, this is for 20 points, and it will be picked up on Friday. And it's going to be on the benchmark test as well, so I want you to know those constructions. All right, let's go on here. Let's find volume. This one right here is a square pyramid. It's a pyramid because it comes to a point, and it's called a square because obviously the bottom is a square. So the formula is volume is big B times H. And since it comes to a point, you divide by 3. Well, the base, the bottom, the area of the bottom is 5 times 5. So the bottom is 25 times the height divided by 3. So that looks like 250. Divide it by 3, and on your calculator, let's see if we can do this one. 250 divided by 3 equals 83.3 repeating. And this is going to be cubic inches. Okay, that's for the square pyramid. Let's go on. The next one is a cylinder. And a cylinder, you don't divide by 3, so it's going to be volume equals big B times H. The bottom is a circle, so it's going to be pi radius squared times H. And so when we finish this up, we're going to end up with pi, which is 3.14, times the radius squared. The radius is going to be 5 times 5 times the height, which is 20. So you take your calculator. I do 25, 5 times 5. So 25 times 20, press equals, and then times 3.14, and I get 1570 cubic inches because it's volume. All right, the last one is a cone. The cone, the bottom is a circle. So put pi radius squared for the big B times the height, and since it comes to a point, you divide by 3. So it's 3.14 times the radius twice, so that's 3 times 3 times the height, and then divide by 3. When you divide by 3, because it comes to a point, you can knock out that 3 right there, and you can say 30, 3 times 10. So 30 times 3.14, and what I get is 942 cubic inches. Okay, you can reduce a top number and a bottom number when you're multiplying. All right, put away your bell work. Today is a trapezoidal pyramid and a triangular pyramid, and to do those, we're going to look right here in the book. So this is 4.6, I think. I'm going to do the trapezoidal pyramid first. Okay, so I'm going to zoom in. And I want you to draw this diagram. Now, some of you are like, well, I really don't know how to draw this diagram. And that's a fair statement. So let me go a little bit smaller so I can get it in here. Okay, so what you do is you just start off with the bottom. Okay, the bottom is a trapezoid. So you draw your trapezoid first, which looks something like that. And then you put a dot at about 12 o'clock and connect the vertices. These are called vertices, these points here. And there it is. That is a trapezoidal pyramid. And the height here of the trapezoid, see, there's two heights. There's the height of the pyramid, which is this one, and there's the height of the trapezoid, which is this one. So you got two heights going on here. And I'm going to use the diagram in the book because it is a little bit better. So I'm going to say volume of a trapezoidal prism, or pyramid rather, is going to be the trapezoid. It's going to be big B times H divided by 3. That's your formula, so write that down. But big B is a trapezoid. So the trapezoid is 1/2 the height times the sum of the two bases. And then times the height of this thing, the height of the trapezoid, let me say it again. The height of the pyramid is 3. The height of the trapezoid is 4. So right here you're going to put a 4. So it's going to be 1/2 of 4, which is the trapezoid. Your bases are the ones that are parallel. And it looks like this one is 6 and this one is 3. So put 6 plus 3 times the height of the pyramid, which is 3. And then you're going to divide by 3 because it is it comes to a point. It's a pyramid. Anyway, this 3 can cancel out. So you're going to get 9 times 4 divided by 2. And that's going to be your answer. So clear your calculator out. So 9 times 4 and then divide it by 2. And that gives you 18. So it should be 18 square feet, or rather cubic feet, because it's volume. All right, I hope that didn't confuse you. Let's say you don't understand how to reduce. Then just go ahead and take 9 times 3 times 4, divide it by 2, and then divide by 3. Okay? Try it on your calculator just to make sure. This one right here is a triangular pyramid because the base is a triangle. Okay, so you have two heights here. You have the height of the pyramid and the height of the triangle. So let's write the formula. So put volume equals big B times H, and since it comes to a point, divide by 3. The only difference here is the base is a triangle. And let me show you how to draw this one real quick. So the bottom is a triangle, so you draw a straight line like this, and then you draw these. And I guess this one should have been dotted as well, but it's okay. And then connect them, and you have your triangular pyramid. Anyway, the formula for the area of a triangle is 1/2 base times height. Remember, triangle, trapezoid's half. The height of the pyramid is 10, and then you have to divide by 3. Well, the base here looks like 6, and the height looks like 4, is what I'm going to say. So it's going to be 1/2 of 6 times 4 times 10, and then the last thing I'm going to do is divide by 3. So clear your calculator out. We're going to just reduce, or rather not reduce this one. We're just going to work it. So let me minimize this so I can get all my work in for you. Okay, anyway, clear your calculator. 4 times 10 is 40, so press 40 times 6, press equals, and then divide by 2, and then divide by 3, and you should have your answer. It should be 40 cubic inches. So use your calculator and make sure you get 40 cubic inches. I'm just about done. I don't know that there's anything else that I need to show you. So we're going to do 4.6 today. And it looks like we have, let's see, quite a few problems. There's 25 of them. And the one I didn't show you is something called a sphere. So let me show you that right now before I tell you what to do. All right, so we're going to draw this sphere. A sphere is basically a ball, like a basketball, okay, or the earth. So put S-P-H-E-R-E, and the formula for volume is 4/3 pi radius cubed. Remember that those are the same, and this is the formula. So here we go. So volume is going to be 4 times pi times the radius cubed divided by 3. Well, the diameter here is 14, so the radius is going to be 7, 7, and 7. So you're going to get your calculator. There's a special key on this calculator. I'm going to point it out to you. It's an XY key, which is this one right here. So clear it out. You could do 7 times 7 times 7, or you could just say 7, press the XY key, and raise it to the third power, and you get this. So 7 times 7 times 7 is 343 times 3.14 times 4, press equals, and then divide by 3. When you do that, you get 1436.02. We'll just say 0.0. It's important that you say 0.0 because they let you know, or you let someone know, that you rounded it off. So it's cubic millimeters. And that is how you do the volume of a sphere. So try to memorize this formula. 4/3 pi radius cubed. Say it to yourself and write it each time. So your assignment is 4.6, 1 through 25, the odd. Make sure you draw the diagrams. If you finish early, go back to your work from yesterday. Have a good morning.